What up, world? My name is Joshua Foster, and I'm doing this for my behavioral science course at Full Sail University. The whole reason for this video is I need to diversify myself. So what I'm going to do is put myself in a position that I never thought I'll be in. And this will be very uncomfortable for me. So enjoy it while it lasts, because it may be the last time I do it. What I'm going to do for y'all is go to a karaoke bar and attempt to sing. If you know me, you know I hate doing things like this. I'm a performer, but I hate getting put on the spot to actually use my voice to sing. So we're gonna see how this goes. Follow me. Worldwide! Play the ball, no.
We ain't gon' leave till 4 in the morning. $1,000 cap, what, I can afford it. On my fourth drink, but I'm not an alcoholic. Shorty say she want me, she way too scrawny. By 4 o'clock, I might be too horny to go home lonely, I can't be lonely. Left the last club, cause the DJ was born. Came back, Valley Park, in the valet robbing. Nigga, true story, that was 12:40. By 1 o'clock, I was back in the worry. Tipsy, Ferrari, this Hennessy got me. Oh, baby, I'm so sorry.
But if you're drinking what I'm drinking, put your hands up in the sky. If you're thinking what I'm thinking, you'll say, what a crazy night. Way-oh, 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 a crazy night. Way-oh.
We ain't gonna leave till 4, maybe later. Yes. Track so funky, make you make an ugly face. Run that back of me, start.
As I started to approach and get closer to the venue, I started to feel the pressure a little bit. I was obviously nervous and started to think about, you know, what song should I sing, what type of song should I sing. But at the same time, the anxiety turned into excitement. I was interested to see what type of people would be there. One stereotype that I had, it would be a lot of intoxicated individuals, probably some wannabe singers or people who never really made it. And so I was very curious to see what type of crowd it would be. The question about do I think I would empathize with the people I meet? I'm a music lover, so I think I would empathize with their love for music and their passion for doing what they're doing. However, I won't be too in tune into why they're doing what they're doing. So I will mingle and I'll talk to a few people there and ask them, you know, what made you decide to do karaoke? You know, what passion do you have with music? Are you just out here to have fun? Or is this really something you want to pursue as a profession? Those are the biggest questions I want to ask them, and, you know, see what kind of feedback they give me and what kind of response I'll get from asking those questions. And maybe I'll find a little bit something about myself that I didn't know, because singing will bring that out of you. It will bring that inner child, if you will, or that inner passion that you never knew you had, to just release that energy and see what type of feedback you get from the crowd by releasing that energy. Well, as I pulled up to the place, again, the nerves started to hit me a little bit. But the excitement was there. I was driving in a parking lot. I seen a lot of traffic. I seen a lot of people headed towards the city walk. I know they have the movie theater and a theme parked over there. But, you know, in my mind, I was figuring everybody is going to sing karaoke. So as I started to walk around and take a look at the scene, this was actually my first time at city walk. So I really enjoyed like the layout and the pageantry of the whole place. It was very, very comforting. So I started to walk up the steps, and I was a little lost at the beginning, but I finally found the place where I wanted to be, and that was the Rising Star Karaoke. It's a very nice setup. They have it set up where they have a live band and also backup singers that stand right behind you as you're singing. And that kind of breaks the ice also, because it gives you a sense of, okay, I'm not doing this alone.